Gentlemen, and welcome into Flying Cardinal Football here on UDTV. If you'll notice, this is a different camera angle than we had last week, as we are back on the home side of the field for tonight's District 1 5A PIAA first round playoff matchup, where the Upper Dublin Flying Cardinals are hosting the number 5 Radnor Red Raiders. The Raiders come into this game with a record of 5-5, and the Cardinals with a record what? That's what I said. I said the number 5 Cardinals. The number 5 Cardinals are going to host the number 12 Radnor Red Raiders on this windy night. It's not very cold, but it is very, the wind is gusting out here. It'll be interesting to see how that affects the kicking game. Cardinals coming off of a tough 21-20 thriller at Upper Moreland to finish tied for second place in the conference. And the Red Raiders are coming into this game and they're looking for a W. The Red Raiders. What? You think? The Radnor Red Raiders coming into this game after a week long at their school of LM Week, Lower Merion Week, similar to WIS Week at Upper Dublin and Spirit Week. This is their big class Spirit Week. They build up to the LM game, and Radnor not historically a playoff team, but playoffs are today, and their LM game is scheduled for tomorrow, so it'll be interesting to see what they do on their end. It's not plugged in. It's not plugged in. Okay, I know. I'm going to. After you plug it in. This is the second time the Radnor Red Raiders have ever made it to the playoffs in school history. And right before you know it, we're going to be underway here from Cardinal Stadium. The Radnor Red Raiders with extraordinarily difficult jerseys to read with white on white writing. I don't know whose idea that was. Zoom out. Radnor, ready to kick this one away. Wind gusting towards the south end of the end zone at about 10, 15 miles an hour. That's end over end. It's going to be fielded by Mike Slifka at the 5-yard line. Slifka with the reverse. Slifka to Bisaccio. Ryan Bisaccio is going to look for a hole. Ryan Bisaccio, he's going to get across the 50. Right, Jack Jamieson, excuse me. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. He's at the 5. Touchdown, Cardinals, on the opening kickoff. And it looks like they're going to call it back on a flag. I don't see a flag on the field. That was a truly beautiful play to be drawn up by the special teams coaches, and it looks like that's coming back. What? They are?
Yeah.
How do you know?
You just said six.
Let's see what the call is here. Personal foul on the Cardinals. And just like that, that call is negated. Well, I got Jamison and Bisaccio mixed up, so maybe it's a little bit better than it wasn't counted. Just kidding. We want all the points we can get. So an unfortunate break for the Cardinals, and instead of starting with the point after attempt, why are they starting them all the way back at the 10? They're going to be starting at the 15-yard line with a very questionable call by these officials. So we're going to see the Upper Dublin offense led by senior captain quarterback, number 9, Julian Gimble. I know. They're in my pocket. Gimble under center. He's going to give it to Bootman for the first time of the night. Bootman is going to hit the line. He's going to get no gain. A tough break for the Cardinals. They were looking to get out early and stun this team. But instead, they're going to start at the 15-yard line. Second and 10 for the Cardinals. The snap. Gimble is going to roll. Gimble's going to be hit in the backfield, and he's nearly going to evade that one. He's going to fall at the 15-yard line for another no gain, and it's going to be a third and long for the Cardinals. The Radnor Red Raiders coming into this game with fury early on. Third and long for the Cardinals. Gimble's going to line up in the shotgun for this one with Malik Bootman to his right. Gimble takes the snap. He's looking. He's feeling pressure. He's not going to go down. There's a flag on that play. Two flags on that play. And Gimble's going to throw that one away. Presumably a penalty on the Red Raiders. But we will see after the referees make up their decision. Face mask on the Red Raiders. And it is my absolute pleasure to be joined by Sam's Italian Market's own, Charlie Hug. Charlie, thank you for joining us.
Glad I could be here, Merms.
Glad you could be here, too. All right, do the penalties offset? Is there a penalty on Upper Dublin? All right, they just don't know what they're doing. So then why are they still standing there? Looks like they're going to give Cardinals a first down there. Right, move. We're staying away from the wind. The wind's coming that way. So I'll have to, like, we'll figure it out. We'll figure it out. So first and 10 for the Cardinals from the 30-yard line. Gimble under center. Takes the snap. They give us to Bootman. Bootman gets a quick three. Red Raiders uniforms virtually impossible to see with the bare eye, naked eye, excuse me. Only possible to see with my handy dandy binoculars. Thanks, Mom. Gimble under center in the goal line formation. Gimble takes the snap. The give is in the backfield to Bootman. Shakes off some defenders, and he is plowing forward, and he's going to get about 3 yards on that one.
And there you see the strength of Bootman. Had a defender on him at the beginning, able to shake him off and pick up an extra 2 or 3 yards on that one.
Thanks, Courtney. Stop. We almost lost it. Third and 5 for the Cardinals. Very manageable yardage here. Gimble takes the snap. He's going to roll out to his left. Gimble is going to fire way over the head of Bootman. That one sails over, and that ball looked like it slipped. And we're going to see Chris Barbera come on for the first time, punting into the wind.
Yeah, and he had his target open there, just overthrew it a little bit over the outstretched arms of Malik Bootman. Could have resulted in a first down, but he missed communication there, and now we have the punting unit on for Upper Dublin.
Absolutely, Charlie. Looks like Gimble got a little bit too... Yeah, you got to stay over here. It looks like Gimble got a little bit too antsy on that one, and it's a low snap by Pollock. To Barbera, that's going to take a favorable bounce for Upper Dublin. It's going to bounce to the 20-yard line down by Jared Pollock. Julian Gimble, number 9, the quarterback, starting on tonight's defense, I believe for the second time of the season. Mike Slifka, the sophomore at free safety. And we're going to see the Red Raiders offense for the first time. Takes the snap, looks to his left. He's going to fire that one long. And, you know, when you're throwing to Haynes Island, you cannot expect to get a completion.
Yeah, he's one of the better quarters that we have on this team, and it's a hard thing to do for a quarterback to find the receiver open against number 1, Selvin Haynes.
Selvin Haynes, 15 solo tackles coming into this one. 27 assists on tackles, played a pivotal role on this team, especially towards the second half of the season. So we're going to see 2nd and 10 for the Radnor Red Raiders. Man in motion, takes the snap. The give is to number 7 in the backfield, 7 on the sweep. He's going to get bottled up and gang-tackled by the Cardinals for a significant loss of about 5 yards. Red Raiders have a 3rd and long coming up. I don't know who the quarterback is because he's not on the roster. McKenna takes the snap. He drops. He's looking to throw. He fires that one. And Zlotnikov gets an errant arm out there. And it's going to be incomplete. And it's going to be interesting to see what the Red Raiders do on 4th down.
And we're going to see the Radnor's punting unit come out here, and they're punting against the wind, which will give the ball a few more yards, and it will have a bad effect on this Upper Dublin punt return.
Mike Slifka, coach is confident in his abilities, as they have been all season. Punt, a good punt. Slifka's going to take this one. He's going to see what he can do. Slifka runs right up the middle. Mike Slifka looking for room to run. Mike Slifka on the near side of the field. Mike Slifka is going to find room, and he's going to bobble the ball, and it is going to go out of bounds. It looks like the Cardinals are going to maintain possession. Mike Slifka, heart might have skipped a beat on that one, but it's still going to be Cardinals football with favorable field position.
And you can see it there. The future is bright for this kid, not only starting safety, but punt return. And if he can keep returning like that, Upper Dublin will have a big improvement in this game and be able to get good yardage.
So 1st and 10 for the Cardinals from the 18-yard line. Julian Gimble in the shotgun with Bootman to his left. Gimble sends Roselli from his right. The give is to Bootman on the delayed handoff, and Bootman is going to get taken down by his ankles, and it looks like the 15-yard line.
Good play there by Radnor's defense, able to keep Malik Bootman down. Malik's going to have a big game for us today if we're going to have any chance in this. He's going to need to break free for some big runs and touchdowns.
We interviewed Coach Stover earlier this week, and they have been evaluating this Radnor defense all week, and they stick to their schemes, but they do have some things up their sleeves. That wasn't meant to be a rhyme. As that gives to Bootman up the middle, it's going to take about 3 Raiders to take down Bootman, and he's going to fall about to the 10-yard line, and it looks like he's going to be just shy of the first down. Third and 2 for the Cardinals. This is definitely 4 down territory. Julian Gimble in the shotgun with Malik Bootman to his left. Gimble, the give is to Bootman. Bootman is going to shake off some defenders, and he is going to be just short of the goal line, and he looks like he's going to fall around the two.
You have to imagine that with all of this wind, we're going to see a lot more of this Upper Dublin running game as these conditions of the weather are going to affect the throw, the accuracy of these throws tonight.
Not a lot. There's a backpack there. Courtney, do not see the backpack. You have to move it up.
Stop.
No, you're just not.
Stop.
Goal line formation for the Cardinals. They give us to Bootman one more time. And they're going to mark him short of that one. Second to go for the Cardinals.
I'm on camera.
Good, I'm glad.
Just don't move my camera.
Then how about this? You move the backpack over here, so then you can move over a little bit. No, you're good.
I'm good.
Cardinals going to give this one another try on second and goal. Just about two. Gimble in goal line formation. Takes the snap. The give is to Bootman one more time. Bootman's going to be stopped short. It's going to be third down. The give to Bootman looks inevitable, but you never know what Coach Stover's going to draw up.
Yeah, and being this close to the goal line, you said it best. Stover, you never know what he's going to do. They could be going in on for fourth, and it looks like that's what they're going to do as Gimble comes back out and the offense stays on the field.
Definitely in four down territory, being so close to the goal line. Red Raiders looking for a stop. Cardinals once again in goal line formation. Gimble takes the snap. The give is, he's going to keep it, and he's going to get that one to Malik Bootman out of the backfield for the touchdown.
Beautiful execution on that play there. Gimble able to rolls out to his right, finds a wide open Malik Bootman who's able to score on the 1.5 yard touchdown play. Plays like that are going to keep us in this game and really give us a big edge against the Radnor Red Raiders.
Absolutely, Charlie. That was a beautiful play. We're going to see what Chris Barbera can do kicking into the wind. Snap, the hold. Oh, and they're going to fake it. Gimble, he's going to run. Gimble's going to break some ankles. It's going to be, what are they going to call? Looks like they're going to call a penalty. All right. I'm uncertain as to what the call is going to be on this one. We're going to see what the refs come up with. There's a flag on the field. We're going to see what the referees have decided to do here. Looks like they're going to bring it back to another area code. Coach Stover standing in awe. So they're going to move this. All right, this ref honestly couldn't be slower. Might be the slowest referee I've ever seen.
Yeah, and penalties flagged this Upper Dublin team last week against Upper Moreland. We'll see how the penalties can affect them tonight against Radnor.
Barbera kicking into the wind from the 15-yard line a lot longer than he would have liked. The snap, the hold, the kick is good. He toe blows that one, and he gets it through the uprights. And your score is going to be 7-0 in favor of the Flying Cardinals.
Therefore, we got to take the ball back where it was when he blew the whistle.
An inadvertent whistle there.
Yeah. Look, well, I understand it blows it dead, but we're back on the 5-6 yard line.
Well,
it blows it dead.
Well, would you rather have been holding it and have to like bring it to his mouth? That wastes a lot of time.
Yeah, but the kicker is, if he doesn't blow the whistle, we got a 2-point conversion.
Exactly. Was that a bobble or is that the sign?
And then we got to move it back 5.
But he got it done. And Chris Barbera is going to kick the other way. The Cardinals Cardinals are going to look to get back on the board. All right, excuse me. Going to look to give the Raiders a tough time coming off this kickoff.
Yeah, Upper Dublin's special team is going to have to stop Radnor here for a big return. Hopefully they can keep him at good field position and have the defense at good position to keep this Radnor team from scoring.
Barbera is going to get ready to kick this one away. Cardinals tightening up on their formation. And that one is off. End over end for Barbera. It's going to be fielded at the 15. Radnor takes it across. Zlotnikov with a diving stop at the 45-yard line. And if Zlotnikov weren't there, I don't know if we would have stopped him.
Yeah, that could have been really dangerous for the Upper Dublin team. Luckily, Dylan Zlotnikov was able to make an athletic tackle and bring this Radnor returner down at the 45-yard line.
First and 10 for the Red Raiders from the 45-yard line. Man in motion. McKenna takes the snap. Delayed handoff. He's going to get bodied in the backfield at the 40-yard line. Send that one to Bleacher Report.
And Weinberg has been a huge part of this Upper Dublin defense this year, able to make many tackles in the backfield, tackles for losses, and preventing big plays against the opposing teams.
The marching Cardinals appropriately playing the Jaws theme song. He might as well have been Jaws on that one. McKenna in the shotgun. Takes the snap. He's going to drop. He's going to fire that one over the middle. And he's going to have his receiver. And he's going to be in for the touchdown. Blown coverage for number 6, Anthony Sermonera. And just like that, they're back on the board. Another flag. And I hate to say it, but it looks like We're gonna see some calls reminiscent of last week against the Golden Bears, where you couldn't go a play without hearing a whistle.
And fortunately for Upper Dublin, it looks like this touchdown will be called back. We're waiting for the call on the field, but Radnor has moved back.
Looks like it's gonna be holding on the Red Raiders. Coach Sowers, please. Coach Stover, please. And all the Cardinals fans, please. McKenna in the shotgun, takes a snap, he's going to drop. He's looking to his left, nearly wrapped up in the backfield. That's going to be fired, and Selvin Haynes is going to get in there to swat that one away. Haynes having a day early on in this game. It's fine. Beautiful pass breakup by Selvin Haynes. These Cardinals, very fundamentally sound. You got to give it up to the coaches for that one. If they can't get there first, they are very fundamentally sound with reaching around to get the ball out of the hands of the receiver without committing a penalty. So it's going to be third and an entire era, like the Mesozoic to the Jurassic. As McKenna's going to take the snap, he's going to roll to his right. Cardinals swarming, and he's going to get hit as he throws by Dylan Zlotnikov, rushing into the backfield. And a flag on the play. What's that? Once again, yet another flag. And an intentional penalty against the Raiders, and that's going to push them back even further.
And this Upper Dublin defense is looking really good right now. Even with that penalty being called, this defense is putting pressure on the Upper Dublin's quarterback, or Radnor's quarterback, and their running backs. And this front seven of Upper Dublin is looking really good so far.
And the punt, nearly blocked by the Cardinals, but a beauty at that. Slifka is going to be careful to hold this, breaks some ankles at the 40. Slifka looking for running room. Gets a block from Haynes. Slifka falls at the 40-yard line. It's going to be first and 10 in enemy territory for the Flying Cardinals.
And he just demonstrated on that play. He is a sophomore playing like a senior out there. You can see the patience he had, waiting for the blocks to come, surveying the field, and just finding his hole, and he's able to pick up a good amount of yardage on that return.
Last week, Coach Dover compared him to being as cool as a cucumber, and I would say he's just that. Gimble takes the snap at the 45. He's going to give it to Bootman. Bootman's going to keep pushing, and he's going to fall at the 35-yard line for a gain of about five.
And this Cardinals run game is going to have to step it up. They've been playing great the past couple games with a lot of big plays tonight. They could be able to take over this game pretty quickly.
Malik Bootman, a 1,000-yard rusher on this up-and-flying Cardinals team. Over 1,000 yards, 1,126. And with 3 minutes and 20 seconds to go, it's going to be second and manageable for the Cardinals. Amir Lewis across the formation. And number 99 for the Raiders, he couldn't even try to cover that one up. He was off by a mile and a half. That is, we don't have his number. He's probably better that way. He doesn't want to get humiliated on the broadcast.
I think he was spoiled, huh?
There was like 25 on the
You know, something in high school that is similar to the dilemma we just had is they don't announce who the penalty is on. They just announce the team. Now, I don't know if that's like a lazy thing or they can't see who it is or they just don't want to humiliate the players that do dumb things like that. But it's going to be an automatic first down for the Cardinals at the Raiders 31. Gimble in the shotgun with Bootman to his left. Gimble takes the snap. They give us to Bootman. Bootman cuts back, and he's going to fall at the 27 for a gain of 3.
And as we talk about Upper Dublin's rushing the attack, not only are the running backs good, but the quarterback, Julian Gimble, has great feet. He's able to run this year for over 200 yards on 44 rushes.
Julian Gimble, definitely a dual-threat quarterback with his legs and with his arm. Gimble once again in the shotgun. They give us to Bootman again. And Bootman's going to be dropped for little to no gain. It's going to be third down and about 7 for the Flying Cardinals. Once again, if you haven't already, go on Twitter. Follow @UD_broadcasting for comprehensive live tweets from all events we're covering. Yes, we have Ross Newman, the sophomore. No, coming out of Lake Drive right off of L Block, and he's doing a great job on the live tweet game for us today. Gimble in the shotgun on third down, sends Roselli to his left. He's going to roll to his left. He's looking for Roselli. Has Roselli for the first down. Roselli cuts back, and Roselli is going to fall forward to the 12-yard line for a first and 10 for the Flying Cardinals.
And that's what he does best. Lucas Roselli able to use his feet and his quickness. He's very shifty in this backfield. He's able to get away from the defender on that one and pick up an extra couple yards and keep this drive alive.
Roselli, this is his secondary sport. Lacrosse is his first, a face-off man. And you got to be quick to be a face-off man. And he really shows that, attribute, fast twitch muscle fibers. And it's going to be, let's see if they give it to him again. It's possible, send him to the right. Gimble takes the snap, and the give is to Bootman. Bootman shakes off some defenders, and he's going to be in for the touchdown. Malik Bootman making it look like we're back at Thomas Fitzwater in the parking lot, and it's going to be, pending the PAT, 13-0 in favor of the Flying Cardinals with 58 seconds to go in the quarter.
And Bootman is really something special. He had about 3 defenders on him, able to break free from all of them, dive into the end zone to give the Upper Dublin Cardinals a 2-score lead over Radnor as we're still in this first quarter.
Bootman's 20th rushing touchdown of the season. It sure seems like he's had a lot more than that. Barbera kicks that one through from even closer than he was before. And normal PAT practices those all the time. And the Cardinals are going to take a hike to kick this one off with the score being 14-0, just under a minute to go in the first quarter. We at Upper Dublin Broadcasting are elated to be back next to the marching Cardinals. We missed them last home game when we were on the other side of the press box. Marching Cardinals, they just bring like a good vibe to the stadium. They're always playing upbeat tunes, getting the fans into it, and the game's really not the same without them.
And not only the Marching Cardinals, but this Upper Dublin student section tonight is a whiteout here for this first playoff game, and this student section is looking tremendously fierce tonight. Everyone you can see is in blue, or I'm sorry, white. And yes, you got that right, Merms. Yeah, you know that it has to be intimidating for this Radnor team, seeing all these people cheering on their team, and it has to get loud in here.
Certainly inspired by Penn State's whiteout, but we're not at Penn State. We're at Upper Dublin High School in Fort Washington, Pennsylvania, right off the 309, right off of 309, the Ambler exit, and at Lockhouse Avenue. Barbera is going to take his customary steps back. It's so cold. It's not that like that cold, but we're just slurring our words. Barbera's going to kick that one off. A low dribbler. And number 7, it looks like, is going to get destroyed at the 35-yard line. Number 7 would be none other than Jamier Ryder, the junior running back for the Riders. I need you to... You just messed up the level, I think. I don't think we said this in the pregame show, but these teams, I don't think they've ever played each other, ever, in school history. According to the, what's that bureau? The sports bureau? I don't know. ESPN stats and info. McKenna takes the snap. The give is in the backfield. He's going to get stopped for a big loss. And the Cardinals are going to rip him down back to the 30-yard line. The Cardinals have a 3 iPad rotation as opposed to the typical 2. McKenna in the shotgun, man in motion. The give is on the sweep. Zlotnikov finds the outside and rips him out of bounds, assisted by Haynes. Haynes had to be very careful about being caught on that late hit. Are they going to call it? What do they want? And no, that's actually going to be the end of the first quarter. We'll see you right after this quick commercial break. And you're watching Cardinal football here on UDTV. Welcome back into Flying Cardinal football here on UDTV. They've switched sides. It's going to be third down for the Raiders. McKenna drops, feeling pressure. McKenna looking to dump this one. He floats that one, and Haynes is going to break that one up. It looks like they're going to call a late hit on Max Weinbrake in the backfield on the quarterback, McKenna. Intended for Vernon Harper. I think that was really like a last resort throw. It looked like he just wanted to dump that one off before he got mangled by Max Weinbrake. And they're going to push that one the other way. It looks like they're going to give a late hit on Max Weinbrake. And is that a late hit or is that a roughing the passer? We're going to go with roughing the passer on that one. 15 yards. Did he say first down and forever? Mr. Redigan pulling out jokes left and right. McKenna in the shotgun just behind midfield. Takes the snap. They give it to the back, and he's going to get about 4 yards. This Radnor Red Raider team looking early to try to draw the Cardinals offsides with a hard count, but it has not worked yet. We're going to see if they keep trying it or they go back to their bread and butter with a silent count. I learned about that the hard way in elementary school when we didn't know when they were calling hike. Once again at midfield, McKenna drops, fires to his left, and that one sails out of bounds. That's still in the air going towards Sparks Field, and it lands now. It's going to be third and about 7 for the Red Raiders.
Yeah, and with this passing game, you have to imagine how many more passes we'll see tonight with all this wind. It will definitely affect the throws of this, and Radnor hasn't been using its rushing offense much. Looks like the Upper Dublin's front line is getting to them, so they're going to have to keep throwing the ball.
The Red Raiders have been throwing the ball a lot this season in their conference, where it's very tough with some of those teams. McKenna, he's going to drop, he's going to survey, he's going to hit his receiver on the outside, and he's going to go. Going to get juke out of defender. He's going to get dropped at the 20-yard line. Jameer Ryder. Jameer Ryder of the Radnor Red Raiders gets a completion on that one. Slips by a few Upper Dublin defenders to be first and 10 for the for the Red Raiders from the 22-yard line. Pulls the receiver back into the backfield, and he gives it off to him. It's going to be dropped. That's Ryder once again. I think I was mistaken. I think the Red Raiders are more of a run team this season, and they tried the pass game. They saw if they could feel out the defense. Obviously, our brick wall, they can't get by it, and they're going to go back to the run game. Ryder's definitely going to take a beating in the trenches. We're going to see how long that will last before they have to take him out. Second and about 5 for the Red Raiders. McKenna takes the snap, fakes the handoff. Haynes is going to rip him back. Oh, and Haynes, oh geez. No call on that one. Haynes wanted to throw him down into the inner mantle of the earth, but he could do no such thing. It's almost like what we saw first down. It's almost like we saw when Kiko Alonso carried his offensive man 13 yards so he didn't drop him.
I like your vocabulary.
Thank you. Special shout out to Dr. Schmidt, Earth and Space Science, 372, fifth period. McKenna in the shotgun on first and goal. Yeah, and it's going to be hit out of bounds. And short gain for the Red Raiders.
Upper Dublin's defense has been really taking care of this Radnor rushing game. Nothing much is getting done with the rushes. Same with the throws. Hopefully this Upper Dublin defense is able to keep it up tonight.
Red Raiders in scoring position. The Cardinals looking to hold them to 3. I can't see. Cardinals switching. And it's going to be timeout for the Cardinals. Coach Sowers, confusion there. Whoa, 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 Charlie, hold your horses. Get it there.
Horses.
During this TV timeout, 76ers are winning. Robert Covington and Ben Simmons with 2 big dunks. Got an ESPN alert, quote, Ben Simmons and Robert Covington get the 76ers going quick with 2 big dunks. Trust the process as always. Am I right, Charlie?
You are right. But, Brian, I'm just wondering, what do you think a big dunk is as opposed to a little dunk?
I don't know. I'd say one that mangles the rim. Maybe they have to replace it. I actually read Shaq's biography in, like, third grade, and he said that he dunked in high school, and the rim was, like, curved in 2 different places because he just obliterated it. And his dad grounded him because he was showing off. McKenna in the shotgun, takes the snap, he's going to look to his left, look into the corner of the end zone, and you cannot throw it to Haynes Island, and they're going to call a foul on that one. Selvin Haynes actually was nowhere near, his hand was to his side. He just went in and swiper no swiping it out, and that's an awful call by the referees. Haynes and Sowers pleading to the refs. Haynes holding up his hands in innocence, and I don't think the referees are looking for beggars. Swiper, no swiping. Slifer?
Slifer, no swiping.
That's not funny.
Yes, it is.
Red Raiders, more favorable field position. A very, 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 very questionable call on that one. And it's going to be like second and inches for the Red Raiders. Takes the snap, and he's going to be in for the touchdown. Looks like the Red Raiders did not get the memo that they are the Red Raiders. Their fans also wearing white. We're the home team, so I think we take precedence. A definite miscommunication by the Red Raider students.
Yeah, you got that right, Merms. Looks like they're all... the colors are really scattered over there. The majority is white, but yeah, this Upper Dublin student section really powers over those white across the field.
They actually call themselves the Radnor Ruckus. And... Cardinals are going to take a hike on this one. Is this a circus theme song? Na 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 na. I was at Radnor's graduation this year. A close family friend graduated the Leah Kors Center, Temple down Broad Street. Heard this one or two times.
What is it?
Their fight song?
Oh, that's their fight song?
Yeah. Na 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 na. Coach Sowers and Coach Stover are furious about that call. They would like that one back. As the Cardinals looked like they had a lot of defensive momentum, and they very easily could have stopped the Red Raiders offense from getting into the end zone. But instead, the score is going to be 14-7 with the Red Raiders kicking off and 8 minutes and 38 seconds to go in the half. The kick is off, it's low. Back to field it is Slifka. Slifka crosses the 20. Mike Slifka breaks tackles. Another flag on the play. Slifka stays on his feet. Mike Slifka, call him Harry Houdini. He falls at the 35, but we're going to see what the referees decide to do.
It's against Upper Dublin.
Where can I hear your commentary?
UD Media on YouTube. This will be posted in like 3 weeks, but the computer we edited on is probably the slowest computer in the entire school. So like when we have to upload something to YouTube, like we leave it and then we have to like leave it overnight to upload, and then we come back in the morning and it's like at 85%.
What the hell kind of computer is that?
Gimble in the shotgun. He's going to keep it himself. Gimble's going to run in the middle. Gimble's going to find a hole. He's going to fall to the 30-yard line. Gimble's not going to slide. He does play baseball, but he stays on his feet and takes that hit. It's going to be first down for the Cardinals.
Yeah, and with this weather tonight, they're going to need a lot more of that. Gimble's arm might not be as effective as it usually is, but his feet will always be working, and you can see it there, able to pick up a big gain on that play and get Upper Dublin the first down.
Julian Gimble, a physical quarterback. Gimble once again in the shotgun formation. Bootman to his left. High snap, and Bootman trips, and that's going to be a loss of about 2 yards on that one. Loss of one. As according to our statistician, Josh Portney, Julian Gimble has 44 carries for 279 rushing yards. Probably a lot more than that coming into this game, but it seems like whenever the Cardinals are in a predicament, Gimble's always available to bail them out. Second and 12 for the Cardinals. Gimble once again in the shotgun. Sends Roselli across the formation. And Gimble's going to keep it once again. Gimble fighting for every last yard. He's going to fall at the 33-yard line. And it's going to bring him about 3rd and 8.
And the play calling from Upper Dublin has been great tonight. Lots of trick plays. That one was fake handoff and quarterback keep. We saw the pitch on the first kickoff and also the fake kick for the extra point. Stover has been calling some great plays tonight.
Coach Stover and Coach Winters, the two-headed monster of play calling. And they put together a great offensive package for this game, and we haven't even seen all of it yet. Gimble's going to call a timeout, and we're going to step aside for a quick minute. And with 6 minutes and 35 seconds left, we'll be right back here with Cardinal Football on UDTV. Welcome back into Flying Cardinal Football here on UDTV. 3rd and long for the Cardinals. Roselli empties the near side. Gimble looking to throw, rolling. Gimble's going to reverse field. Domino effect, and he's going to have Jameson for the first down. Jameson pulled down by his horse collar. We have horses actually behind us, and that's going to be a horse collar. And it looks like the Cardinals are going to be able to tack on a few more after that long reception by Jack Jameson.
Yeah, and a great play there. Gimble able to use his feet to avoid and keep the play going, able to find Jack Jameson along the near sideline, able to pick up a couple extra yards. And after that penalty, the drive keeps moving up forward. It's a great drive for Upper Dublin so far.
Jack Jameson surely knows patience. In fact, he parks behind me in the Performing Arts Center. And, you know, when it's at the end of the day and everyone's trying to get out, he waits his turn and doesn't try to like cause any accidents in the parking lot. He's really respectful, and it's a great attribute to see out of any of these players. And Gimble takes the snap at the 45 in the shotgun. He's going to roll to his right, and he's going to have Roselli, and it looks like they're not going to call that one a catch. He cannot secure that, and it's going to be 2nd and 10 for the Cardinals. Gimble reminds me, his NFL player comparison, Carson Wentz, able to elude all tacklers, get out of any situation, and make a play out of nothing.
Yeah, the body type is not quite there, but the skill is able to use his feet, has long throws, great elusiveness. Yeah, this kid's looking really good for Upper Dublin.
And the grit. You do, you're shaking, and you're like holding your hand. Gimble in the shotgun sends Roselli to his right. Takes a snap, and they give it to Bootman. Bootman with a spin move, and he is going to fall forward. That could have been called targeting on that one. It went right for the helmet, helmet-to-helmet contact, but it's going to be 3rd and long for the Flying Cardinals. Cardinals not exactly in field goal range. No, they're not in field goal range, Portney. I can guarantee it. Yeah, Jake Elliott would have been able to do it, but Chris Barbera is no Jake Elliott. Gimble in the shotgun, standing in his own 45-yard line. Rolls to his right. That's going to be a hold on the Cardinals, and that's going to be a fumble, and it's going to be out of bounds before the Raiders could fall on that one. But it's going to be a long – that ball is going to cut that – jeez, the line of scrimmage is going to move back. They caught Chris Smith on a hold there. The Red Raiders pleading with all their might to get that fumble recovery, which is just ludicrous because they got nowhere near it. But we're going to see what this brings up for the Cardinals.
Yeah, Merms, don't feel too bad. If the viewers of this video were here tonight, they would understand our speech. It is a very chilly night here at Cardinal Stadium.
You know, according to the weather, it's not that chilly. But this wind, woo! Barbera standing at the 35-yard line. Returner, number 12, standing at the 15-yard line. Snap a little bit to Barbera's left, and he's going to be able to get that one away. Spiral. It's going to bounce into the end zone. Oh, it's going to stay, and the Cardinals are going to down that. The Cardinals are going to down that at the 5-yard line. A beautiful bounce by Chris Barbera. Just how he drew it up, Charlie.
Yeah, you can't ask for a better bounce than that. Looks like it was almost guaranteed to go into the end zone, able to make hook it left and bounce down to behind the 10-yard line. Great field position for this Upper Dublin defense.
Johnny Hecker, the punter for the Los Angeles Rams, has actually turned punting into an R for him. And he, like a baseball pitcher, has pitches that he throws, fastball, changeup, curveball. Johnny Hecker has about 11 different punts that he can do at any given time. More on that in a second. McKenna tries to draw the Cardinals off sides, but they give it to Ryder, and Ryder is going to get hit by a flock of Cardinals, and he's going to fall at about the 6-yard line for a gain of 1.
Again, the Upper Dublin run defense is looking really good tonight, not letting them get many big plays. Of course, every run is going to get some yards, but they're able to hold it to a good gain this time.
As I was saying, Johnny Hecker of the LA Rams, he can hit a left to right ball, he can hit a right to left ball, he can hit one that goes up and then dies right down, he can hit him end over end, spiral, he can do it all. Barbera definitely striving to be like that. McKenna nearly in his own end zone. And that ball is going to be jarred out by Bootman. Looks like they're going to call that one incomplete. Bootman almost got that one out in passing. Meaning, not in passing, like obviously that was a pass, but he was running by him and just stuck his arm out last minute and jarred that one loose.
Yeah, great instincts there by Malik Bootman. Looking like a cat there, able to stick his paw out and grab that ball. Cat-like reflexes.
Meow. Meow. It's actually 3rd and 10 if you see the 3 and then the 10-yard. 3rd and 10 out of their own end zone, standing in his own end zone, line of scrimmage at the 5-7. McKenna drops. He's going to look to his left. McKenna's going to fire that one long, and he's going to not have his man. Oh, and I thought that was a flag. It's actually just the Radnor marching band throwing up flags. I just saw a flash of white going up towards that direction. That was a real scare, Charlie.
It was also a scare for the Upper Dublin defense. He had his receiver open, just underthrew him a little bit. That could have been very dangerous.
The Red Raiders have definitely learned their lesson not to throw to Haynes Island, as they haven't done it since. So, Selvin Haynes really making a name for himself in this game. Punter standing in the back of his own end zone, nearly blocked by the Cardinals. And they're going to let that one bounce backwards. Mike Slifka thought about returning that. Slifka, you know, he is still a sophomore. He usually does play like a veteran, but it's decisions like those. You know, he's feeling the pressure. It's Friday Night Lights, playoffs. He would have liked to have gotten a return on that, but that could have been dangerous had he touched it and the Cardinals not fallen.
Yeah, that could have been dangerous there. He's still learning. You always need to pick up things, and he definitely is going to learn from that experience.
We're watching that one on film. Might turn it into a live video and make it his background, his inspiration. Film courtesy of Mike Young. He's about 6th year doing it for the program. Gimble takes a snap, standing at the 50. Gimble's going to keep it. He's going to be pushed back. Looks like they're just going to give him no gain with forward progress. Three minutes and counting, and the Cardinals would like to get another touchdown going into the end zone. A 2-score lead would be ideal, but any lead is great. Gimble once again in the shotgun, sends Ains across to his left. Gimble dropping, feeling pressure. He's going to be hit as he throws. His arm was, I don't know, they're going to call that an interception. And just like that, a fumble. What is this? If the arm's going forward, that's a fumble?
I think it was his hand, but not that. He didn't actually throw it.
So that's a fumble.
He knocked it out of his hand, yeah.
Missed coverage on the corner for the Cardinals. No, there's been cockpit protection all game. He just missed that one guy slipping around the outside. And now, instead of the Cardinals threatening, the Raiders are gonna have the ball at the 40-yard line. 1st and 10 with 3 minutes to go. The Cardinals would love to get a stop here. I mean, on this drive, not on this play. I mean, they'd love one on this play, but first down, they have three more to work with. McKenna drops. He fires to the left, and that is going to be incomplete. Sermonera has to keep his hands down, careful not to be called on pass interference, and it's going to be second and 10 for the Cardinals, for the Red Raiders.
And a good no call there by the refs. That was just great defense, able to keep up with his man all the way down the field, not letting him get in position to catch that ball. Just great play that we've seen tonight from Selvin Haynes.
Haynes Island, call it Barbuda, call it whatever you want. But McKenna's going to be standing at the 45-yard line. McKenna, high snap. The give is to, can't tell who that is, but Roselli with a big tackle, the 33-yard line. It won't connect from down there. I'm really, really upset. I need it. So am I. Yeah, Ross, I think, has data. Yeah. All right, so third down for the Raiders. They need a first down to keep this drive going. They have 2 minutes and 26 seconds until they head to the locker rooms. Calling audibles. McKenna takes the snap. He's going to look to his right. He's going to throw, and Haynes is going to drop him. Looks like they're going to get him short of the first. All right, the first down marker was at the 29-yard line. They stopped him at the 31, but they're going to give him a first down.
Yeah, it's a weird call there. I mean, I trust this Upper Dublin offense, defense to stop them even after that first down pickup. But, yeah, this should not have been a first down on that play.
McKenna in the shotgun trips to his left. McKenna dropping, feeling the pressure. He's going to dump that one off. Nearly picked off for the Cardinals. Jefferson bringing the pressure on that one.
Jefferson. Is he a
sophomore? He's got to be a senior.
Or maybe he's a senior. Is it Amon? Do you know his first name?
Nah, I don't know his first name.
That's the Radner, buddy.
I want to say Jefferson.
Yeah, I'm just going to go with Jefferson. If not, oh well. Second and 10. McKenna with the hard snap once again. Takes the snap. Give us to number 6. And number 6 is going to get bodied. He held it? He fooled me. Minute and 33 seconds to go. And it looks like the Cardinals are going to be content with running out the clock here. Unless the Raiders have a kicking prodigy, they're not in field goal range. The wind is right in their face. Head tap. McKenna splits the receivers. He's going to drop. He's going to throw over the middle. Ooh. Tipped. And nobody was there to pick it off. But Bootman was there to absolutely mangle that receiver had he caught it.
Yeah, and the backfield for this Upper Dublin defense has been all over these receivers. Not able to get much done in this game tonight.
Keep talking.
We have a timeout on the field. Looks like the coach will come out and discuss the play for this play as we're running down time in this first half.
Cameron Ross, zoom in. And we're going to throw it down to Ross Newman on the field. Ross standing by. Ross, how are you doing? Ross. Ross, can you hear me?
Ross needs to go right.
Ross Newman, can you hear me? Move to move towards us. Keep going. Tell me when you get in the field of view.
Yes.
All right.
I can see you.
We're going down to Ross Newman. Ross, how's the atmosphere down there on the field?
Oh, you know, it's great action out here.
Look at the camera.
Everyone's playing really well. And, you know, hopefully Upper Dublin can come out with this win. We'll see what happens.
All right. Thank you to Ross Newman. It's going to be fourth down for the Raiders. McKenna in the shotgun. Takes the snap. Looking. Throwing. He has his man across the middle. Jameson hanging on his back. And that's going to be a first down for the Raiders. Blown coverage for the Cardinals.
Number 7,
It's going to be a timeout on Radnor. And you know what? I think Ross deserves redemption.
Oh my God, it's so cold.
Another timeout here, looking to make the play. And on that play back there, it looked like Jameson was trying to bring the ball out of his hands instead of trying to bring him down. Ended up needing more than one tackler to bring him down.
And we're going to throw it down to Ross Newman once again. Ross, how are the players reacting to these calls from the referees?
Oh, you know, they're not very happy.
Look at the camera.
They're not very happy about them. They really aren't. I don't know.
All right, bye. Special thank you to Ross Newman down there on the field, enduring the cold weather. McKenna in the shotgun on first and goal. He keeps it himself. He's going to throw at, and it's going to be broken up by Anthony Sermonera. All right, you have to tell me if I'm getting in your way.
I'm not going to say it when you're in the middle of the
game. Well, it's better than me getting in the way.
During halftime, you move over as far as you can this way. Yeah.
Me?
No. The captain.
Well, then he can't sit. Oh, actually, you will be able to see if you're closer. Second and goal for the Raiders. No, our Zoom is not nearly enough. Am I in the shot? McKenna in the shotgun, two backs to his sides. McKenna takes the snap. He's going to keep it. He's going to fire over the middle. Throwing to Haynes Island, as I told you before, it's inevitable. It's like the Bermuda Triangle. You get lost, and you can't really get anything out of it.
Yeah, they haven't gotten anything going to their receivers against Selvin Haynes. Hopefully, they're able to keep it up and keep throwing it that way, and Upper Dublin's able to keep stopping it.
Haynes Island doesn't exactly flow as well as Revis Island. Like, Revis Island, like Haynes Island. But we'll make it work. Maybe Selvin Island? Nah. Island Selvin? Nah. We'll figure it out.
Middle name.
Third and goal for the Raiders. Ball at the 10. McKenna rolling to his right. McKenna sees running room, and he's going to get stopped short of the goal line. And they're definitely in four down territory. 35 seconds. The clock is going to keep running. Cardinals fans got to get up. They're not going to because the Bird Gang is always silent. 23 seconds left. And it looks like the Radnor coaches are going to call a timeout, and they're only going to leave enough time for one play to be run. A very interesting strategy from the Radnor coaching staff. Oh, they're not even going to run a play?
6-5-4.
They call timeout, 4 seconds left. Honestly, that was genius.
Yeah, good play calling there by the Radnor team. Able to run the clock down to 3 seconds left, have time left for probably about one play unless they can get a real quick play out to the sideline. But even that, in the 3 seconds won't be enough.
It's fourth down.
It is fourth down. Sorry about my thoughts there. Yeah, it looks like they have time for one play. Looks like they'll go for it here on fourth down, not going to kick it. And we'll see what this defense can do to stop them.
The Bird Gang should get loud. They're not going to. Cardinals looking for a big stop. I'd love it to be like more intense and like me be able to yell, but they're quiet. Bird Gang getting loud. Wow. And it's going to be timeout for Coach Sowers and the Cardinals. I would say it's fine, Portney. Portney, it's really okay. See, but like Portney, like when I say it's okay. Cardinals looking for a big stop here. The front seven expecting a run play, presumably to Jerabide Ryder. We're going to see what he's able to do, or what McKenna is able to do, what the head coach is able to do, what Radnor is able to do. Here on fourth down, enough time to run one play. Are you kidding me?
There's no stats of it. I couldn't find any stats.
That was useless. Bird Gang getting loud. Enough time to run one play. We're going to go into halftime after this one. McKenna in the shotgun. Sends a man in motion to his left. He's going to take the snap. He's rolling. He's looking. Zeros on the clock. Being chased. He's going to get around the outside, and he's looking for the end zone. He's going to dump that, and you cannot. They're going to call a touchdown. He was out of bounds on the end, but it looks like the referees are not going to agree. And with zeros on the clock, pending the extra point, we're going to go into the locker rooms tied.
Yeah, and that's just a tough play there. You can see the cornerback had to make a decision on whether to stay with his man or chase the quarterback. With the quarterback getting that close to the end zone, he had to make a split-second decision to keep him from running into the end zone, which resulted in his receiver being wide open, and that's what happened back at the corner of the end zone. Quarterback able to find his target and score the touchdown with zeros remaining on the clock. And here we have the kickoff, the kick to try to tie the game.
According to our instant replay, he was in. Thank you to Secaucus for providing that. And they're going to put that one through. And instead of a lead or a two-score lead, we're going to go into this one knotted at 14. So a gritty first half by both teams, playing to the top of their ability, feeling the pressure of the first round of the playoffs. We're going to go to a commercial break with the score 14-all against the Radnor Red Raiders. You're watching Cardinal Football here on UDTV. Welcome back into Flying Cardinal Football here on UDTV. Once again, I'm Brian Mermelstein alongside Charlie Hugg, Josh Porton on the camera, and Ross Newman providing live tweets on the field. And we are back to begin the second half with the score 14-14 against the number 12 seed Radnor Red Raiders. Charlie, what are you looking to see out of the Cardinals in this second half?
Looking to get their rushing attack going. They've had some good runs so far. One resulted in a touchdown, but we really need some big plays able to explode down the field. Hopefully get a couple more touchdowns out of their runs. Not just their running backs, but quarterback Julian Gimble too. We've all seen what he can do with his legs, able to run. And hopefully he's able to keep going with that tonight.
Cheerleaders doing jumping jacks. Bird Gang doing star jumps. And Barbera kicks that one. It's a low squib. Cardinals swarming. And they're going to hit him. And he's going to get yanked at the 28. They're going to call a late hit on that one. That is ludicrous. And I'm not talking about the artist. I'm talking about the vocabulary term. Another flag. It looks like there's going to be unsportsmanlike conduct on the Raiders. And I think those penalties are going to offset.
Yeah, it looks like it will.
It is frigid out here.
Oh, thank you.
Keep it in your pockets so it stays warm.
It is currently.
I left work and it's so cold.
Porty, you have to hold this.
What?
This.
I know. I'm holding it.
No, it was shaking. So the penalties are going to offset. Not very good discipline, actually no discipline for the Radnor Raiders. And they're going to have 1st and 10 from their own 30-yard line. McKenna in the shotgun. Takes the snap. And the give is to the back. He's going to get ripped down, but they actually pulled him forward for a first down. Looks like very close to it. Matt Cohen, the back who had that carry. Cohen has had a few big gains. Portney, I promise you he's not lying.
Okay.
Has had a few big gains. He a senior?
He is a junior.
Matt Cohen, a junior. Jamiro Ryder?
Jamil.
Some motion before the snap. The fake is on the sweep. He has Ryder, and Ryder falls at the 47 for a first down. The Raiders coming out early. Hey, Portney, Mike, camera. Nah. McKenna in the shotgun. Cohen to his left. Takes the snap. The give is to Cohen. Cohen's going to get backed up for a small gain. Couldn't tell you what Portney's doing, but definitely not camera. So please get back on that. Second and 11 for the Raiders. McKenna looking to throw here on second down. He's going to have number 23. Haynes is going to miss that tackle. He's going to get taken down by Bootman. Bootman has to be very careful not to get it in that horse collar. And that's going to be Vernon Harper. Something Harper, and he's going to get that first down, and the Raiders are rolling early in the second half. Man, oh man, it is windy out here. We're not in Kansas anymore. We got a motorcycle on 309 getting the fans hype. Portney. McKenna with the give to Cohen. Cohen, there's a flag on the play. Probably going to be against the Cardinals because that's the theme of the game tonight. We're going to see what the Zebras decide to do here.
Yeah, and this it was looking like this game is quickly turning into a three-sided affair. Cardinals versus Raiders versus refs. We'll see how this turns out.
And that's going to be against the Red Raiders. Double. Is that a double call against the Raiders? Oh, and they're going to walk back to a different area code. It's a classic. The Raiders head to the 609, and they're going to have first and, let's count, 20. First and 20 for the Raiders, back at their own 45. McKenna in the shotgun, throws it long, and that is going to be a reception. He's going to be in for the touchdown. Jameson missed coverage on that one, and the Raiders are going to take their first lead of the night, pending the extra point. It's 20-14 in favor of the Radnor Raiders. We have some banging in the booth next to us. Coaches cannot be happy, especially defensive coordinator Ed Wall.
And it almost looks like we've seen that exact same play before on their first touchdown. The wide receiver is just burning the cornerbacks here, having wide open, great throws from the Radnor quarterback. We're going to have to tighten that up on defense.
And it's nearly blocked by Haynes. That would have been a big block, another bang coming from the press box beside us. And the score is going to be 21-14 with 9:07 to go in the third quarter of play. Cardinals, who scored that, do we know, on the Raiders? Awesome. So Cardinals got to put him back on Haynes Island. Why is it so zoomed in? Zoomed in a lot. Yes, it is. It's very zoomed in. Got to put him back on Haynes Island. Jack Jameson is going to have to make a comeback from that one. Definitely not pleased with the way he covered that, but let's take a look at the starting special teams members. On the near side, Brody Balassa, Sam Pullen, Amir Lewis, Nick Sowers, and that's 23, Logan Heim. Dylan Zlotnikoff, Anthony Sermonera, Selvin Haynes in the middle, Lucas Roselli deep, and Bisaccio on the near side, James on the near side, Slefka on the far side, all 11 of them. We got to go back to them. So the unnamed kicker is going to be back to kick this one away. No, he's not. What's his name? Hurry up.
Van Dusen.
Dylan Van Dusen.
Van Dusen. And that's going to bounce into the... Jameson's going to try to turn garbage into gold. Jameson, ah, shist. Jack Jameson gets to the 1 yard line. I don't know what he was thinking, trying to go backwards. North, south, not east, west, but it's going to be first and 10 from the Cardinals from the 1 yard line.
Yeah, that was just a muff play there. Unable to get the kick. Bounces all the way back, almost into their own goal, able to pick it up. And then he runs in the opposite direction. Now they're down right in front of their goal line at about the 2 yard line. This is not looking that great for Upper Dublin offense.
For those of you who are concerned about this broadcast not being PG, I did say schist, which is a foliated metamorphic rock commonly found in the southeastern Pennsylvania area, as Lucas Roselli takes that carry for a short gain of about 2. Mica schist, actually, with the presence of the mineral mica.
Yes, and I've taken many a hike down at Wissahickon, the Wissahickon Creek, and seen a lot of Wissahickon schist. It's a very nice, beautiful rock. I've taken a couple rocks home to show my father.
Really? Wow. Didn't know you were a rock expert like I am. Gimble takes the snap. The give is to Bootman. Bootman falling for every yard. He's going to get to the 7, and it's going to the 6. Sorry, P-Red. And it's going to be 3rd down and 7. 3rd down and 7 for the Cardinals. Bolasa subbing out. Gimble coming on. The Radnor fans, all 4 of them, getting loud across the field. Well, loud is a relative term because, you know, they're weak. Bisaccio in motion. Gimble dropping. Gimble feeling pressure. Gimble rolling to his left. Gimble. He's going to go, and he looks like he's going to get the first down. And they're not going to give it to him. Oh, they're going to nope, I don't know what they're doing. They're not moving the chains. Oh, yeah, they are. They're going to give him the first down. A real sigh of relief for the Cardinals.
Yeah, and that there is what Gimble does best, able to avoid the rush, able to pick up the first down on something that could have been a loss and even a safety in their own end zone. Great play there by quarterback Julian Gimble.
Gimble, a mobile quarterback. Goal line formation for the Cardinals. The give is to Bootman. We saw this in the Oh, wow. A late hit. The Radnor defender dragged down C.J. Staley with him. And looks like Radnor number 9 trying to do the YMCA. I don't know about that, but... What? Hey, Josh, how much time's left?
6 minutes and 57 seconds.
Thanks. Goal line formation for the Cardinals. The pitch is to Roselli on the near side. Roselli, and he takes the hit. That's a late hit. He hit him, I think, when he was already on the sideline. He's going to swallow that hit, and it's going to be... they're going to give it to him for the first down, and the Cardinals are marching early.
Yeah, the Eagles... I'm just going to stop on this one. Merrims, back to you.
Move in front of the ball. Move in front of the ball. Go all the way down. Hurry up.
Cardinals lining up.
In the goal line formation, Gimble takes the snap. The give once again to Bootman. Bootman spinning, stays on his feet, and he's going to fall. Looks like a late hit there, but it's not going to be called. Well, as I was saying, the Cardinals, when they fell 14-0 early on against the Plymouth White Marsh Colonials, it was actually Malik Bootman's idea, according to Coach Stover, who said, go with the goal line formation, and they fed it to him, and they ended up coming out of that game 28-14. The score here, 21-14, and we're going to see if the Cardinals in the goal line formation can stir up some of that same magic. 2nd and long for the Cardinals. Gimble, he's going to roll out to his right. Gimble looking long. He's going to fire. He has Sam Pollen, and there's going to be no call on pass interference. Sam Pollen got shoved out of that one. I don't have any good shoving analogies. Oh, okay. Sam Pollen got shoved like a shuffleboard piece on a cruise ship, and a no call there is going to lead to 3rd and very long from the 28-yard line.
Yeah, we'll let the editors take care of that one, Merms.
The who?
The editors. Well, that might hit the cutting room floor, that analogy there.
I don't understand that one.
That means, like, it's going to get cut.
No, it's not. Shut up. Gimble in the shotgun for third down. Haynes on the near side sends him in motion across the formation to the left. Gimble looking, fires long. He has Ryan Bisaccio for the first down, gets tripped up by his ankles, and he's going to fall at the 43-yard line. Give him an inch more, and he's gone.
What? Stats? No.
And a good play there. He's able to stop and bring the ball into his body. If he kept running, he might have been able to have a chance and keep going on that one as the defender is just able to get his ankle. But nonetheless, it was a great pickup by Ryan Bisaccio.
Last week at Upper Moreland in that devastating 21-20 loss, there were a lot of throws where Bisaccio and Jack Jamison both were able to pitch a 10 under that ball when they were waiting for it like he did there. And the pitch is to Roselli on the – oh, wow, and it's a great gain on the revert – no. What's the word? I don't even know what I'm looking for. The option, the read option? We'll go with the read option.
Yeah, whatever play it was, it worked, and we were able to pick up about – 6 yards on that play.
Second and four for the Cardinals. Gimble in shotgun formation, ball at the 37. Gimble standing at his own at the Raiders 42. Gimble takes the snap. The give is to Bootman. Bootman, and he's going to get dropped. What? They have his number? Call 1-800-STEAMER, Stanley. Yeah, and that's what I don't want you to do. Like I tell you. Your job is to be up here doing camera. Radner's fifth fan stands up to get them going. Gimble looking inevitably to throw here. Haynes on the near side slot, Bisaccio on the near side. Gimble looking to his right. He throws across the middle to Haynes. Haynes has that one. Haynes is going to run. Selvin Haynes is going to turn on the Jets and be in for the touchdown. Selvin Haynes puts the Cardinals back on the board. And are they going to call another penalty? That was an awful call. I'm sorry. I know these broadcasts are supposed to be unbiased. He got in, hit the pylon with his right leg. And for those of you who aren't oriented with your right side and your left side, the right leg is the leg on the outside. So obviously, if he kicks it with the outside of his foot, he had to have been in a disgusting call from the referees. And he's going to rob Selvin Haynes of that one. Coach Stover unhappy. And there's going to be a timeout on the field with the score still 21-14. Charlie, what did you see on that play?
Really, it just looks like I didn't see what the ref saw because that was a call that I do not understand. These refs are really affecting this game in a negative way. Lots of penalties that just aren't looking that well for both sides, not even just Upper Dublin. The officiating is really going to have to step up.
You know, the head referee did put his hands up signaling a touchdown. So did, I think, one or two of the assistants. And especially for this District 1 playoff game, we have, let's count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 referees on the field. You'd think that majority rules on that one, and it looks like that's not going to be the case. One is going to stand his ground, plant his foot, and say, we're going with my call on this one. Looks like we're going to have more of a... we're going to stay with you here on UDTV. Let's take a quick pan to the Bird Gang. Bird Gang wearing white. Almost filling up the entire stands. It's great to see the Bird Gang showing out to tonight's game. What are you doing?
I just fell.
It's not that cold. And
watch me just fall over now.
I'm oddly confused as to the injury on the field as he's standing on his knee, or he's on his knee, looks like he's about to propose. Speaking of proposals, Charlie, did you watch the World Series Game 7?
I did, and I think you know where you're going with this one, Merms, if you would like to take it away and just tell this story.
Carlos Correa of the Houston Astros, while he was getting interviewed by Fox Sports, proposed, in his answer to the question, he said, and my life's about to get a little bit better. And he proposed to the former Miss Texas on live television. It was about 12:30 Eastern Standard Time. And I was still up finishing my math portfolio. Shout out to Mr. Funston. And that proposal was iconic, and it's going to go on forever. That diamond, just enormous, as big as your thumb. So, not a proposal, but an injury. And the Cardinals are, they're going to put Oh, they're going to go with the Wildcat formation here. Bootman's going to take the direct snap. Malik Bootman shakes off a defender, and he's going to be in for the touchdown. You have to tell me!
There's no way, we can't, stop. Don't move my camera.
Move.
Cut off.
Why does it look slanted? Why is there no parallel mark?
And then takes off.
Thank you for moving it.
You're welcome. We are very sorry, but I hope my commentary is good enough that you don't even have to see it.
Show not tell.
Barbera.
Tell not tell.
Gimbal from Pollock. Barbera puts that one through. And it's going to be 21 all with 4 minutes and 8 seconds to go. No. Why? What good is that going to do me so I can get in your shot again?
Oh, no.
Am I missing my glasses? No, I am not. Special shout out to Alan Twer, my eye doctor and beloved neighbor. Honestly, a great guy. Gives us his Diamond Club tickets whenever he doesn't go to Phillies games. Great guy. Twer Eye Care Associates.
Northeast Philadelphia.
Can you zoom out? These are very zoomed in. No. You're all the way zoomed in, Courtney. Oh, my God. Are you kidding me?
You don't want to see these players, do you?
Yes, you do. Barbera runs up, and he's going to kick this one away. It's going to be that's not an onside kick, but a squib. And the knee was down when he got that one. He's going to be down at the 35-yard line. It's better than a touchback, but it's going to be first and 10 for the Radnor Raiders. Coming back from that. Well.
I know, neither.
McKenna out to lead his offense once again with 4:06 to go in the quarter. McKenna in the shotgun takes the snap, fakes it to Cohen, throws it in the flat, and he's going to get the missed tackle by Roselli, and he's going to get out of bounds, and he's going to be short of midfield. Looks like a little bit of a defensive breakdown for the Cardinals. Charlie?
Yeah, I mean, there was a good block there. I got a couple good blocks, able to get the runner some room. But, yeah, just a couple missed tackles on that one.
Shist. McKenna in the shotgun once again takes the snap. The give is on the sweep to number 26. I don't know his name.
There's no 26.
Something Bardabada, according to P-Red. I can't really hear him that well. Special thank you to Josh Portney, statistician, roster collector, and all-around great guy. Is the wind like a lot? Shist.
I heard that loud.
That's a lot better, actually. Look. McKenna takes the snap, fakes the handoff. McKenna rolling, feeling the pressure. And that is nearly intercepted by Anthony Sermonera. Max Weinbrake has to be very careful. He pushed over McKenna after he threw it. That could have been called a late hit. Last week at Upper Moreland, I was actually reviewing the game tape, and Mike Slifka, the sophomore, when he was in for Julian towards the end of the game, took a vicious hit after he got rid of the ball. Should have been a late hit there, but it wasn't. And so it's going to be third and long at about midfield for the Radnor Raiders. The fans getting loud, the Bird Gang not so much. Big third down here. Takes a snap, he's going to look. He's going to fire to Haynes Island, and he's not going to have his man. To be fourth down from about the 50-yard line.
there a flag? Do you see a flag? I don't see a flag. No.
Fourth and eight for the Raiders. Looking to punt here. Punting unit comes on. I believe the wind is no longer coming from the north end of the end zone. It is coming from directly across us. If that's the north end, that's the west end. The west side, west to east at about 15 miles an hour, 20 mile an hour gusts. That punt, wobbler, it's going to, oh geez, it's going to take a favorable bounce for the Raiders. And the Raiders are going to pin the Cardinals at the 3 yard line. Slifka's decision there definitely influenced by his near catastrophe earlier on in the game. And that was definitely the right decision by Mike Slifka.
Yeah, and as I said, he learned from that play earlier. He knew that it would be a bad idea to touch that ball on the ground. If he touched it and didn't pick it up, it would be Radnor ball there. So a good choice by him to not touch that ball and just have to deal with the fact that they're now at the 2 yard line.
From the shed and it went all the way down, you can just like put the iPad on it and zip it down.
First and 10 from no man's land for the Cardinals. Gimble in the shotgun, the give is to Bootman. Bootman shaking off defenders, gains about 4 on that one. 2:32 and counting. Holy shist, it is windy out here. Gusts of 25 miles an hour at Cardinal Stadium coming from the northeast. Gimble under center. Takes the snap, and the pitch is to Roselli. Roselli trying to find the outside. Roselli cuts back, dips, ducks, dodges, and dives, and he's going to get to about the 12, and it looks like they're going to bring up third and short for the Cardinals. First down. Oh, how generous.
And you can see how complete this Upper Dublin running back crew is. We have Malik Bootman, who is able to grow a north and south runner, able to power through people, and then we have Lucas Rosales, you just saw, able to run east and west, able to use his speed and shiftiness to pick up an extra couple yards on that one.
Cardinals once again in goal line formation. Bootman the lone back. A vicious hit. Bootman finds the outside. Bootman cuts back. Bootman, oh, and he falls at the 35. A vicious hit in the backfield for the Upper Dublin Flying Cardinals. What do you see there, Charlie?
Another great run by this Upper Dublin rushing team. And as you see there, Malik Bootman is not only a north-south runner. He's able to get on to the near side of the field, pick up a couple extra yards with that cutback. And, yeah, as I said before, this running attack is going to need to improve, and it looks like it is in these last couple of minutes here.
In the third quarter. 1:11 to go. The pitch is to Roselli. Roselli cuts back, misses it. Oh, he just – Roselli with the agility of a cat. And he's going to go to the 40-yard line. He probably ran about 20 yards on that one, but got only 4.
Yeah, but that's what we needed. If he hadn't done that, it probably would have been a loss of about 2 or 3, able to turn that negative yardage into positive yardage with those extra couple steps that he took.
Let's go UD chant. Is that UD? Let's go UD. Bird gang, silent. Cardinals once again in goal line formation. Roselli the lone back. The give is to Roselli on the misdirection. And Roselli gets kicked in the head while he was down. Scary play there. Not acceptable in PIAA District 1 5A first round playoff action. But the referees are going to look the other way. That's going to be 3rd and about 7 for the Cardinals.
10 seconds.
10, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. 3-2-1, and that's the end of 3, and we're headed into the final frame here with the score knotted at 21. We will be right back after this commercial break here with Cardinal Football on UDTV.
Not again.
Welcome back into Flying Cardinal Football here on UDTV. Brian Mermelstein once again coming back, and we are headed into the fourth quarter with the score knotted at 21. Team switch sides, and 3rd down from the 40-yard line for the Cardinals as Gimble lines up in the shotgun. Bootman He has Bootman in the flat. Bootman is going to get a first down and a little bit more. Bootman across the 40, tries to cut back and gets hit out of bounds at the 35. And it is going to be first and 10 with the Cardinals rolling with the first play of the fourth quarter.
And the Cardinals have been driving lately, able to get a lot of big yardage on their plays. They're looking to pick up their momentum here. And this band is really hyping them up too, as well as Brian Mermelstein.
It is frigid out here as Mr. Griner joins us up on the perch. Yeah. First and 10. Gimbel drops. He's going to go. He's going to run. He looks. He fires. And he has Belasa. Belasa. And he's going to get the catch. Belasa had 1 foot in high school and college. The rule is you only need 1 foot. And that's going to be a beautiful catch by Brody Belasa, the tight end.
And what an acrobatic play there. Able to keep 1 foot in and make the catch along the near sideline. Oh, beautiful play there.
It hurts to clap. I want to clap, but I can't. Cardinals amped. Frank Brady tries to get the Bird Gang hyped to no avail. Jeez. I'm about to call Dr. Schmidt. Like, yo, Doc, I didn't know there was an Arctic front coming in. First and 10 from the 26-yard line. Gimbel in the shotgun. The give is to Bootman. Bootman shakes off defenders. Bootman gets down to the 20-yard line for second and about two. Malik Bootman at the end of that run, he actually, the ball got drawn up to his chest. He still had it, but it was up to his chest. That's very scary. You got to keep it tucked in between your elbow and your shoulder and like the 5 points, two hands. I saw it on TV once. Special shout out to our sponsors, Hot Hands, performing hand warmers. Whoa, sir, give him a yellow card. There's a penalty flag.
Ball start again. That's like the second time today.
Offsides against the Raiders, and it's going to be first down for the Cardinals. They didn't even have to run an offensive play. They got a first down.
Yeah, and that's what we need. That helped our... That helped the Cardinals out a lot. Hopefully they're able to keep the momentum up and score a touchdown on this drive.
Burr! Jameson on the near side. Haynes in the slot. Passaccio out to the top of your screen. And another flag. The ref threw that flag up. He tried to throw it like vertically. And the wind actually blew it right back into him. And a false start on the Cardinals. You know what? But it is first down, not second down. So we can be grateful for that offsetting each other. Radnor Raider marching band playing All the Lights by Kanye West. Mr. Griner,
I'm leaving the warmth already. We're only there like 30 seconds.
Gimbel in the shotgun. The give is to Bootman up the middle. Bootman has some blocks. Bootman was held there. You saw his jersey get ripped. Maybe not a hold, but he's going to get down to the 13. Come on, P-Red. Yeah, P-Red agrees with me. 13, not 14. And it's going to be second and manageable for the Cardinals. Second and not... Oh, yeah, because they were set back. Josh Portney sniffling. Would not be surprised if any of us woke up with cold-like symptoms in the morning. Not to be confused with cat concussion-like symptoms. Bootman finds a block, and Bootman has Never Everland. Call him Peter Pan. He's in there for the touchdown. And that's number 21 on the year. Does he have all three tonight? Or no? But it's 28. That's his third one of the night. Ryan Bisaccio with a mediocre effort to get the Bird Gang hyped. Oh, that upper double in alma mater sounds beautiful after a nice Cardinal touchdown.
Yeah, and you know this has to get this team feeling great. Taking a lead here. Oh, as the field goal gets blocked, the extra point gets blocked. But nonetheless, the Cardinals are just taking a lead. This alma mater is pumping them up. Let's see if they can keep the momentum up and get this stop on defense.
And a rare blocked field goal for Chris Barbera. point after attempt. I apologize. You can't get too comfortable with those chip shots. You got to take everyone seriously. And the lead, now a 6-point game, 27-21 in favor of the Flying Cardinals with 10:02 to go in the game. The winner of this game will go on to play the winner of the, I believe, Academy Park is the 4. The Academy Park number 4 versus Chichester, the 13 game, hosted at Academy Park tonight. None of those schools are schools that we usually play, as I'm not even going to say it. And who's Hannah? I don't want to know. As I was saying, I'm sorry, the Marching Cardinals just get me distracted every time. Chichester and Academy Park, both a hike and a half away towards the airport. And if the Cardinals do win here, they will be taking a trek. And we will be going... No, we didn't. That's not the Northeast. No, it's not. That's like... No. No, you're... Yeah. He did not grow up there. Nah. Ah, the ball falls off the tee. It looks like they're going to need a holder. There's no way this stays. And they're going to bring in Zlotnikov to hold. Just kidding. Barbera's going to try to kick this while it stays. Barbera gets ready to boot this one away. And the ball stays on the tee. He gets that one off. Is it going to stay in bounds? Yes, it is. It's going to be in for a touchback.
Yeah, that one was unable to get a lucky bounce for Upper Dublin as it did a couple kicks ago. Nonetheless, this Upper Dublin Cardinals defense does have the momentum from that last score to keep this Radnor team from scoring.
Oh, holy shit. Chuck. Can I call you Chuck?
Go ahead.
Does anybody call you Chuck? Nobody calls you Chuck.
Couple people.
Really?
Couple people.
McKenna in the shotgun, Cohen to his right. On 1st and 10 from the 20-yard line, he stands at his 15. McKenna takes the snap. The give is to Cohen on the sweep. Cohen looks for the outside. Cohen finds a few blocks and gets pancake, tackled, whatever you want to call it. And he's going to be down at the 25. Frankenstein. We got flash photography coming from the Radnor stands.
Is that allowed?
Nope. McKenna in the shotgun, standing at his own 20-yard line. Ball at the 25. McKenna, the give on the delayed handoff is to Cohen. There's going to be a flag on the play, but they're going to drop him for a loss. Coach Stover really wants to know what that call is. Coach Stover getting his exercise, running up and down the field to ask the referees what the call is. That's going to be a hold against the Raiders, and we're moving back. Coach Stover likes to be involved with all facets of this game, whether it be offense or defense. He always wants to be involved with the conversations with the referees, the play calls. He's really always there, and... whatever. They didn't even really push them back. Oh, yeah, there. There we go. They realized that there was a penalty. Referees almost forgot. I mean, it took 7 of them, but they figured it out. And that ball is going to be spotted at... Oh, they have 2 footballs now. What in tarnation? What the heck? What the heck, Tate? McKenna and the shotgun takes the throws over the middle, and Sermonera puts him through the spin cycle, and he's going to get dropped at the 25-yard line, and it's going to be 3rd and about 6 for the Raiders.
There's nothing really to say about that play, but Brian, where do you come up with this stuff?
Look, can't reveal my sources. Holy shist. Under 9 minutes to play. Clock is ticking. Special shout out to Ross Newman bearing the cold down there in the bowl. And it's going to be a timeout called by the Radnor Red Raiders. We're going to take a quick timeout here on UDTV, and we'll see you right after this. Welcome back into Cardinal football, and it's going to be 3rd and 5 for the Radnor Red Raiders, standing at the 20-yard line, ball at the 15. McKenna, flag on the play, and that's going to be called dead. It looks like it's going to be movement against the Raiders. False start on the Raiders, push them back, and it's going to be 3rd and 10. Third and 10 for Radnor from their own 20-yard line.
Trying to find Scrolls Yellow Greens.
It's okay. Just look up Academy Park. Literally, no, they're not in Suburban 1. No, they're not in Suburban 1. Look up Academy Park. And then just search.
And he's going to get pulled down by Chris Smith. Chris Smith, the animal. Literally, call him a T-Rex, call him an Allosaurus, call him a Stegosaurus. He is an animal back there and rips down McKenna, sends him to another dimension on that sack, and it's 4th and an area code for the Raiders.
And you can feel the ground shake from up here. You know that has to make the defense feel good, a great play like that, having to bring out the punting unit, and hopefully we can see what this Upper Dublin offense can do.
Punting into the wind. Oh, Sauer's nearly on that one. It's a very, 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 very short punt. And it's going to get a favorable bounce for the Cardinals. And the Cardinals are going to have extraordinary field position at the 26-yard line. That might have been the worst punt I've seen all season.
You have to take in the factor of the wind as well as just a muffed punt there. Very fortunate for the Upper Dublin offense being able to start this drive from inside their own 30-yard line.
Academy Park.
My baby don't matter. Mr. Horns at 1, 2, 3. I thought it was Hey Ya by Outkast. High snap to Gimble. The give is to Bootman up the middle. Bootman shakes off a defender and falls for about a gain of 3. I got the magic, baby. Haynes and Gimble coming on. Roselli. Roselli trots off the field. Second and 10. They're going to give Bootman no progress. Bootman takes this. Gimble takes the snap. He's surveying. Surveying still. It's going to be a free play, and he's going to get hit and throw still. And he's not going to have Brody Bolasa, but there was a flag before that was thrown. That actually reminded me of a very, very, very specific play from the North Penn game in the district championship 2 years ago, where Ryan Stover was on the near side, about to fall out of bounds, and hit Rapine on that same sideline. An iconic play. Cardinals couldn't get a reception there, and actually there was a hold. So, actually, whoa! I don't know what that's all about. I think the refs are just taking out their anger. Must have not been good with the misses last night. Cardinals, 2nd and an eternity. Third and 20, under 7 to go. 2nd and 20. Gimble alone in the backfield, takes the snap. He's rolling to his right. Gimble throws it long, and he does not have... Brian Bisaccio, 8, 8, the number 8 and the number 0 look very similar from this distance, and that might have been more favorable if Gimble just ran that one to the outside.
Yeah, and he had wide open field in front of him. It was just a bad decision there, unable to connect. If he had him, it would have been a great play, but he should have taken the easier way and just ran that one.
Now, don't get me wrong. Gimble is a mobile quarterback, and he can throw off of his back foot, but it's much less of a low percentage completion rate when you can just take it yourself. 3rd and eternity for the Cardinals. They're going to at least look to bite off some more yards. Gimble drops. He's rolling. Gimble evades a tackler. Julian Gimble has Ryan Bisaccio. Bisaccio is going to get wrapped up at the 25 to the line of scrimmage. And Coach Stover is going to have a decision to make here. I don't think they're in field goal range. They're going to need a throw here if they want to get a first down. And it looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down.
Well, why not?
Why not? Because it's the district playoffs. But, I mean, I guess Portney's right. Fourth and seven for the Cardinals. This wouldn't exactly, like, seal the game. But, I mean, either way, the Radnor Raiders will not have good field position after this play. Gimbel in the shotgun. Bootman to his right. Gimbel takes the snap. He drops. He's looking. He fires. And he does not have Lucas Roselli. And it's going the other way. Gimbel takes responsibility for that miss. And they're going. The Raiders are going to take possession at the 28-yard line with 5 minutes and 58 seconds to go. I don't think you can waste 5 minutes and 58 seconds on one drive, but these Raiders have shown to be very good at clock management. So we will see what they decide to do on this drive.
Yeah, and with about half the quarter remaining, we'll see what they can do if they're able to run down the clock and get a score. It is a 6-point game, so as long as they just score a touchdown, the game is tied.
Pending an extra point. McKenna in the shotgun. High snap. The give is to Cohen. Cohen gets stopped for a short gain. Cohen didn't even know it was coming for him. He, like, looked. I saw that. He looked up. He's like, ah, you're going to give me the ball, and he just put it in his chest. Second and about 6 yards for the Raiders. Ball at the 29. McKenna in the shotgun. Two receivers to his left, one to his right. McKenna takes the snap. The give is to Cohen. Cohen gets stopped immediately for a large loss of yards. And he's going to be dropped at the 26-yard line to make it third and about 8 yards. A stop here for the Cardinals will be huge. Bird Gang should be on their feet. They're on their feet, but they're not loud. Fans should be getting hype. They're not. Defense chant trying to be started by Blake Bayless to no avail. Blake Bayless, member of the golf team. Shout out, golf team, Squalf. This play is huge. McKenna in the shotgun. McKenna takes the snap. He's dropping. He's surveying the field. He's feeling pressure from Smith. He evades, and he is going to get put for a spin cycle. He tried to go one way. Smith had other plans, and he's dropped to the 30-yard line, and it looks like the Raiders are going to be in four down territory. Oh, I don't know. What do you see there on that stop for the Cardinals?
I saw great hustle by their defense. Once the quarterback starts running, the defense has to make a decision on whether to stay with their man in their zone or go pick him up. Great decision that time.
Looks like they're going to punt. I would not be surprised if we saw a fake. And that is going to be punted away. Short punt. It looks like it's going to take a favorable bounce for the Cardinals. It's going to fall at the 44-yard line. And with 3 minutes and 47 seconds left, the Cardinals have the ball.
Okay. Give me 2 first down, game's over.
I like the assessment.
Okay. 2 first downs making me up one timeout.
Is Jules going to win?
What?
Jules on this side?
No, he's not related to me. Is he here?
No.
What a schmuck.
But he's green part. He's going to lose. We're going to crush.
Goal line formation for the Cardinals. Gimbel decides to keep it for himself. Gimbel throws that one away, and he gets trashed after the throw. Gimbel looking to dump that one off as to not get sacked, which he did, but it took him a little bit more time, and he still took a vicious hit.
He's going to let it run all the way down and call timeout.
Coach Stover looks like he's going to let the clock run down. Play clock at 10. Wait, why is the clock not running?
Because it was an incomplete pass.
You're right. So why'd they have to... I don't understand that. First of the second half, Cardinals left with 2 timeouts as they get 3. Do we have any other things we want to talk about?
I
can't really think.
Let's plug our sponsors. Hot Hands, providing all your hand warmer needs. Sam's Italian Market, for all your Italian food needs. Mention, tell them Charlie sent you to get a 15% discount on any good you choose to purchase from Sam's Italian Market. Mad Mex, home of the $11, could be $15 nachos.
With tip, it does turn into $15. Just make sure you go with someone that doesn't make you pay them back.
Absolutely, and gas money is a high commodity nowadays. Ludicrous. The marching band getting into it late in the game. So are the cheerleaders, so are the bird gang. Yeah. Hey, we're going to be back to the field. Please zoom out, Portney. All right. Yeah, you're good. Goal line formation, 2nd and 10. Gimbel under center. Delayed handoff to Bootman. Bootman looking for a block. Bootman gets dropped just short of a first down. And number 9 of Radnor begging for Widow Wefa Wee to give him a call. What do you? Who? What else do you expect? 3rd and 1. 3 minutes and 13 seconds left. Coach Stover is going to want to snap this at the last possible second, and I don't blame him. It's like a basketball team where they say, hold for one, and then when the shot clock gets down to like 7, you start the play. But this, you can snap it as late as 0 or 1. Gimbel, eye on the play clock. Gimbel under center. The give is to Bootman. Bootman's going to be short of the first, and it's decision-making time for the Cardinals. Cardinals are going to let this clock run, and if the play clock gets started, and the Cardinals are going to go for it here. Looks like they're going to be able to run the clock to about 2 minutes, just over 2 minutes. 4th down for the Cardinals. We're going to see what Coach Stover decides to do here. 14-13, Gimbel still standing. Coach Stover looks like he's going to call a timeout, his second one of the game, his second one of the half.
Put the clock back in the line.
Coach Stover calls timeout with 1 second left. And with 2:07 to go in the final frame, it is decision-making time for Coach Stover and the Flying Cardinals. Let's just give you some context. The ball is at the 48-yard line of Radnor. There are 2 minutes and 7 seconds on the clock. It is about 4th and 1. And a first down might just seal it for the Cardinals.
And Coach Brett Stover is no stranger to gutsy calls. Last week at Upper Moreland, going for 2 on the final play of the game after they just scored a touchdown with 3 seconds to go. We'll see what he can come up with here on this 4th and 2 with 2 minutes remaining here in the game.
Looks like they're gonna go for it. Coach Stover confident in his offense. If Radnor can come up with a stop here, that could be dangerous for the Cardinals. Coach Stover getting his team hype. He is fired up. Coach Stover showing all of his emotion out there. And we're going to see what the Cardinals can do here. First down might just seal it. Coach Stover firing up the fans. Gimbel under center. And the Radnor Raiders jump. And that looks to be... that could be the most costly offsides ever. Is that on them? And that is going to might just seal the game. A first down, an extraordinarily costly offsides, might be the worst penalizing offsides of his career. And with 2:07 to go, the Cardinals are going to have first instead of fourth. And you can bet any amount of money in the world that the offense is going to stay on the field. First down, Gimbel under center. The give is to Bootman. Bootman shakes, spins, keeps going, and he's going to fall to the 33. And it looks like not the 38, P. Red. They're not going to give him a first. Oh, are they?
Yeah, they should. They have to.
Oh, wow.
They are.
Timeout for the Raiders, and with 1 minute 58 seconds to go, Chris Horn and the Marching Cardinals. Oh, I can't reveal the secret yet. But a very familiar song is going to be coming up on the set list. I just overheard the announcement. Any guesses, Charlie?
I couldn't tell you, Merms.
Well, it's inevitable. Rhymes with... I'm not going to tell you.
Hey-ya?
No. Why would they play Hey-ya?
Hey, hey, no.
Ready? Four measures.
Hey, it didn't work out.
Coach Stover telling his team, reaffirmation. Stover off the field. First and 10 for the Cardinals. They're going to give it to him. Goal line formation. Gimbel under center takes the snap. The give is to Bootman. Bootman is making a fool of this Radnor defense. Nah. This is not closing time. They said closing time was up. No, you're no, never zoom. 1:50 to go. Raiders call timeout. The Radnor Red Raiders are out of timeouts. And with 1:50 to go, it's second down.
What song is that?
Goal line formation for the Cardinals. The give on the delayed handoff is to Bootman. Malik Bootman dives to the 20-yard line. He's going to be down for a first. And the clock is just going to... Tick tock on the clock. All right, the clock stops because it's a first down, but
who cares?
Cardinals are just going to let the clock tick tock, tick tock, tick tick, tick tick, tick tick, tick tick, tick tick, tick tick all the way down. And Upper Dublin chants, the Cardinal faithful, also known as the Bird Gang, still out here in full support of their team. Gimbel under center. The give is to Bootman once again. Bootman, and he's going to go down at the 14-yard line. 18-yard line. Nope. P-Red, you're wrong again. We are officially under a minute to go, and with 59 seconds, the play clock starts now. Now it's the song I wanted. Charlie, that would be closing time. How fitting for such a game. Mr. Horn not happy with that one. Clock is going to run. 35, 33. Gimbel takes the knee. And with 28 seconds left, it looks like, aren't they going to make it? And the play clock's not going to start. And that's going to do it for Cardinal football. And the Cardinals are headed to the second round of the PIAA 5A District 1 playoffs, where they'll take on the winner of the Academy Park versus Chichester game. And the final score from tonight's matchup is 27-21 in favor of your Upper Dublin Flying Cardinals. But on behalf of Charlie Hogg and Josh Portney and Ross Newman, I'm Brian Mermelstein saying good night, and we will see you next week for round number 2. This has been Cardinal Football on UDTV. Thank you.